Hi students, today 9 to 10 exam will complete. Now for that few questions are given out of the material, those questions we will discuss. Now question number 1, the greatest and least values of sine inverse x whole square plus cos inverse x whole square. Now this we can write a square plus b square, we can write a plus b whole square minus 2ab. Sin inverse x plus cos inverse x value what? Clearly pi by 2 according to property, whole square minus 2 sin inverse x. This sin in cos inverse x I'll change in terms of sin inverse, how to change? Pi by 2 minus sin inverse x. This is clearly pi square by 4. Multiply inside, 2 to cancel, pi sin inverse x minus of minus plus 2 sin inverse x whole square. Now first order wise write down, 2 sin inverse x whole square minus pi sin inverse x pi square by 4. For easy purpose, I'll consider this symbol is a sin inverse x some t or y, no problem. This will become so what? 2t square minus pi t plus pi square by 4. We need to make this one into perfect squares. How to make perfect square? 2 take common from this overall. T square minus pi by 2 t. Now we will get pi square by 8. From this, 2 into t square minus pi by 2 t. Now just put it in the integration like that concept. T square, a square minus t coefficient what? Pi by 2. In that half value take. Half value means pi by 4. That square value add and subtract. Pi square by 16 minus pi square by 16. This value adding and subtracting. This complete value we can make into perfect square. T minus pi by 4 whole square. If you take LCM 16 here, 2 pi square minus pi square, that is pi square by 16. This is a given function. Now substitute that T. What is the T means? Sin inverse x minus pi by 4 whole square plus pi square by 16. To find least and greatest, it's very simple. When this function becomes least, the least value, if you take this is complete function is f of x, f of x is least if sin inverse x is pi by 4. Substitute here, we'll get least value. 2 into sin inverse x is pi by 4, this value 0. Pi square by 16. Multiply with 2 inside, what will get least value? Pi square by 8. F of x is greatest if this sin inverse x is a minus pi by 2. Not pi by 2 ma. To get the greatest, we need to take the least value of sin inverse x. Because sin inverse x minus pi by 4, you will get limitation from minus pi by 2 to that values, consideration wise. Minus pi by 2 substitute in the place of sin inverse x. 2 into minus pi by 2 minus pi by 4 whole square plus pi square by 16. 2 into minus 90 minus 45 minus 135. That is minus 3 pi by 4 whole square plus pi square by 16. 2 into what? 9 pi square by 16 plus pi square by 16. Now 2 into 10 pi square by 16. 2 ones are, 2 eights are, 2 fives are, 2 fours are. What is the greatest value? 5 pi square by 4 and least value is pi square by 8. That is option 1 is the correct one. Next, question number 2. The value of summation n equal to 1 to infinity tan inverse of 1 by 1 plus n plus n square. This type of series terms we need to make in the form of tan inverse x minus tan inverse y form. We need to convert whatever given term. Here I am writing 1 by 1 plus, I will take n is common, what you will get? 1 plus n. In the place of numerator 1, I am taking 1 plus n minus n. Clearly in this, which form? Tan inverse of x minus y by 1 plus x into y. Whatever x is, whatever condition, n plus 1 is a x, this is y. Summation n is equal to 1 to infinity tan inverse of 1 plus n minus tan inverse of n. Now substitute the values n 1 to infinity. If you substitute 1, what you will get? 2 tan inverse of 1. Next take 2. 2 plus 1, that is 3, minus tan inverse of 2, plus and so on. Last value, what you will get here? Finally, tan inverse of infinity. Solves infinity, it will be simplified. So all terms cancel except this infinity term, last term, and this minus tan inverse of 1. No other value will get plus tan inverse 1. That's why finally you will get what here? Tan inverse of infinity minus tan inverse of 1. Here tan inverse of infinity what? At which angle? Pi by 2. Tan 1 at which angle? Pi by 4. 90 minus 45, that is 45. 45 means pi by 4. That is option A, 1 is the correct answer. Yeah, you can take T only, no problem. Question number 3. They given if sine inverse of x minus x square by 2, x cube by 4, plus and so on up to infinity, plus cos inverse of x square minus x power 4 by 2, x power 6 by 4, and so on infinity, equal to pi by 2. This is clearly in the form of sine inverse x plus cos inverse x equal to pi by 2. When this is possible, this x value is compulsory equal. That's why first value x minus x square by 4 plus x cube by 2 only, plus and so on equal to x square minus x power 4 by 2, x power 6 by 4, plus and so on up to infinity. This both series are in GP only. In GP, S infinity formula, A by 1 minus R. But here A is a X, R is common ratio, second term by first term. Minus X square by 2 by X means minus X by 2. Here A value X square, R value minus X square by 2. Apply both side S infinity formula, A, that is X by 1 minus R means 1 plus X by 2. X square by 1 by 1 plus X square by 1 plus X square by 2. 1 X value cancel. Take LCM 2, it comes to numerator 2 by 2 plus X. I mean 2 comes to numerator 2X by 2 plus X square. 2 2 cancel, cross multiplication. 2 plus X square equal to X into 2, 2X plus X square. X square, X square cancel. Next 2 2 cancel. What is X value? 1. That is option 1 is the correct one. Next, question number 4. If secant inverse of root of 1 plus x square, cosecant inverse of root of 1 plus y square by y, plus cot inverse of 1 by z equal to pi given, then we need to find x plus y plus z. Here substitution I am taking, x is equal to tan A, y is equal to tan B, z is equal to tan C. have a reason. If you simplify, inside will change into secant. This is cosecant. This is changing to cot. Secant inverse of root of 1 plus tan square is secant square. Root of secant square is, that is secant A. Cosecant inverse of 1 plus tan square that B, that is the secant square B, root of secant will become secant B by tan B. Cot inverse of 1 by tan is a cot equal to pi. Secant inverse secant cancel A. Cosecant inverse of secant we can write 1 by cos, tan you can write sin by cos. Cos cos cancel, 1 by sin means cosecant. Cot inverse cot cancel, C equal to plus pi. Here also cancel. Finally what will get? A plus B plus C is equal to pi. Now A means here A plus B equal to, I can take pi minus C. Apply tan on both sides. Tan of A plus B equal to tan of pi minus C. Formula: tan A plus tan B by 1 minus tan A into tan B. Tan 180 minus theta is minus tan theta. Tan A means x, tan B means y. 1 minus x into y. Minus tan C means z. Cross multiply. X plus y is equal to minus z into 1 minus z. Minus of minus plus x into y into z. Send this minus this side. You will get x plus y plus z equal to x into y into z. This is the required value for question number 4. That is option 2 is the correct one. Next, question number 5. 9 power cos inverse x minus 2 into 3 power cos inverse x plus 1 equal to 0. Then the value of x we need to find out. 9 you can write 3 square. This completely we can write 3 power cos inverse x whole square minus 2 into 3 power cos inverse x plus 1 equal to 0. Clearly this is in the form of a square minus 2ab plus b square. A is a 3 power cos inverse x. This completely we can write 3 power cos inverse x whole square equal to 0. 3 power cos inverse x minus 1 equal to 0. 3 power cos inverse x equal to 1. 3 power cos inverse x equal to 1, I can write 3 power 0. Bases are same, you can compare powers. Cos inverse x equal to 0. X equal to cos 0. And x will how much? 1. That is option 2 is the correct one. Next, 6th one. Tan of 2 tan inverse root 5 minus 1 by 2 plus cot inverse 2. We have formula for 2 tan inverse x. In terms of tan inverse what? Tan inverse of 2x by 1 minus x square. We need to simplify this. That is 2 tan inverse of root of 5 minus 1 by 2. That is tan inverse of 2 into root 5 minus 1 by 2 divided by 1 minus root 5 minus 1 by 2 whole square. Here 2 to cancel. Tan inverse of root 5 minus 1 by 2 square is LCM, that is 4. 4 minus is A minus B whole square. Root 5 whole square 5 plus 1 minus 2 root 5. LCM is already 4 by 4 we are taking. This 4 value comes to numerator. Tan inverse of 4 into root 5 minus 1 by 4. 5 plus 1 6. 4 minus 6, that is minus 2. Minus of minus plus 2 root 5. Tan inverse of 4 into root 5 minus 1 by, I will take 2 common. First I will take positive and the negative. Root 5 minus 1 is cancelled. 2 1s are, 2 2s are. Finally, what value here? Tan inverse of 2. This complete value we got, tan inverse 2. Substitute in that. Tan of, the first value is tan inverse 2. Second value already cot inverse 2. Which formula? tan inverse x plus cot inverse x. What is the formula for that? Pi by 2. Tan pi by 2 is what? Infinity. That means not defined. Not defined there in which option? Option D or 4. Fourth option is the correct one. From 7 to up to 15 as a material questions only. I am not going to discuss again because already we given. Next, question number 16. Summation of I is equal to 1 to 20 sine inverse xi equal to 10 pi. We need to find summation of I is equal to 1 to 20 xi value. Okay, here we need to remember one formula. Summation I is equal to 1 to 2n sine inverse xi equal to n pi is the formula. Similarly, summation I is equal to 1 to 2n xi is equal to 2n, 2 into n. Compare with this one, n value how much? Clearly 10. Substitute in this. I is equal to 1 to 2 into 10, that is 20. Xi is equal to 2 into 10, that is 20 is the answer. It's very easy, ma. Question number 16, option 1 is the correct one. Next. Question number 17. Secant inverse x plus secant inverse y plus secant inverse z equal to 3 pi. Then we need to find xy plus yz plus zx. Remember one thing, the range of secant inverse x is what? Closer interval 0 to pi minus pi by 2. But the least is 0, highest is pi only. That's why we have to take each value is pi, pi, pi only. That's why each one, secant inverse x, secant inverse y, secant inverse z, all are equal to pi. Each one pi means pi plus pi plus pi, you will get 3 pi. If you take secant inverse that side, it will become secant. X, y, z, all are equal to secant pi. Secant pi value how much? Minus 1. We need to find here what? X, y plus y, z plus z, x. X, y, y, z, all are minus 1 only. Minus 1 and minus 1, 1 plus 1 plus 1. What is the answer? 3. That's why, which option is correct? Option 3 is the correct one. Next, question number 19. The given tan inverse x is greater than cot inverse x. The next condition we need to find out. Tan inverse x greater than, according to property cot inverse x, we can write pi by 2 minus tan inverse x. Send this minus tan inverse this side, it will become 2 tan inverse x greater than pi by 2. Divide 2 that side. Is greater than pi by 4. When the converting the inverse trigonometry, tan inverse in terms of trigonometry, inequality not changes. So x is greater than tan pi by 4, that is x is greater than 1 is the inequality, that is option 1 is the correct one. Next, coming to question number 20. Sine inverse of cos of sine inverse of root of 2 minus root 3 by 4 plus cos inverse of root 12 by 4 plus secant inverse of root 2. First, this inside value we need to simplify. That is sine inverse of cos of sine inverse. For numerator and denominator, I'll multiply and divide with 2. I will get here 4 minus 2 root 3 by 8 plus cos inverse of root 12 means 4 3, so that is a 2 root 3 by 4 plus secant inverse root 2 sine inverse of cos of sine inverse of 4 minus 2 root 3, I am writing, can I write root 3 minus 1 whole square. Expand this, root 3 whole square 3 plus b square 1, 3 plus 1 4, minus 2 root 3 will get. Root 8 means I will write 2 root 2. Here 2 1s are, 2 2s are. Cos inverse of root 3 by 2 means cos root 3 by 2 at which angle? Pi by 6. Sin is root 3, secant is root 3, secant not, secant is root 3 at which angle? Root 2 ma. That is pi by 4. Secant is root 2 at which angle? Pi by 4. Here square root is cancel. Sin inverse of cos of what remaining left here? Root 3 minus 1 by 2 root 3, 2 root 2. Sin is root 3 minus 1 by 2 root 2 at which angle? 15 degrees. Sin inverse of this complete 15 degrees means in terms of radians how much? Pi by 12 plus pi by 6 plus pi by 4. Sin inverse of cos of, doubt is right on, 15 degrees, 30 plus 45. Sin inverse of cos of how much? 75 plus 15, 90 degrees. So I cos 90 how much? 0. Sin inverse of 0 means 0. So which answer is correct? Option 1 is the correct one. The first one we need to convert properly ma. They given root 3 minus 1 by 2 root indirectly given, we need to simplify. Next, question number 21. We need to find sin inverse of cos of 43 pi by 5. 43 pi by 5 I can write cos of, I can take 8 pi plus 3 pi by 5. Correct? Take LCM. 40 plus 3, 43. N pi plus theta, where n is an even number. N pi, 2 pi plus theta, 4 pi plus theta, 6 pi plus theta, 8 pi plus theta, all will come to which quadrant? First quadrant. 2 pi minus, 6 pi minus, 4 pi minus, come to fourth quadrant. It's clearly first quadrant. First quadrant, cos is a positive function, not changes. 3 pi plus by 5, it is in the range only, that's why I can change this one in terms of sin. Cos theta I can change into sin 90 minus theta. Sin inverse of sin, simplify this, take LCM, 5 pi minus 6 pi, that is minus pi by 10. Sin, sin inverse cancel. Why I am cancelling? The range of sin inverse is minus, close interval minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 is in the range only, that's why. What is the answer? Minus pi by 10 is the answer. That is option 4. Question number 22 ma. 22. Tan inverse of x plus 2 by x minus tan inverse of 4 by x minus tan inverse of x minus 2 by x equal to 0. For this two, we'll apply formula tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. Take this one right side. Tan inverse x minus tan inverse y formula what? Tan inverse x minus y. By 1 plus x into y. Equal to what you'll get? Tan inverse of 4 by x. Now here xx cancel. You can compare tan inverse also later. Tan inverse of 2 by x plus 2 by x because minus of minus plus 4 by x. So 1 plus a plus b into a minus b, that is x square minus 4 by x square equal to tan inverse of 4 by x. Tan inverse cancel. In next step, 4 by x by 1 plus x square minus 4 by x square equal to 4 by x. I can cancel 4 by x also, reason in options not given 0 value, that's why these two also you can cancel. Cross multiplication, 1 equal to 1 plus x square minus 4 by x square. 1 also cancel. Now take this value left side, 4 by x square equal to x square, 4 equal to x power 4. Here x power 4 equal to, we can write this is 2 square, power is cancelled, x square is equal to 2, x what will get? Root 2, because minus root 2, root 2 also not given, that's why only take positive, that's why minus root 2 is not given, only positive value given, that's why option 1 is the correct one. Next, question number 23, sine inverse A equal to alpha plus beta, sine inverse B equal to alpha minus beta. Okay, from this I will find A value, what is A will get? Sine of alpha plus beta, B is sine of alpha minus beta. Here we need to find the value of sine square alpha plus cos square beta. Now I'll convert this cos square in terms of sine ma, 1 minus sine square beta. Now 1 plus first sine square alpha and then sine square beta. We have formula in trigonometry. This is the formula for sine of A plus B into sine of A minus B. So 1 plus sine of alpha plus beta is small a, this is small b, that's why answer is what? 1 plus A into B, that is option 2 is the correct one. Next, question number 24, x equal to 2 sine of 2 tan inverse 2, y equal to sine of 1 by 2 into tan inverse of 4 by 3. Here we need to build the relation between x and y. Okay, na? X equal to 2, simplify this. We have formula 2 tan inverse x in terms of sine inverse. 2x, 2 into 2 by 1 plus x square, 2 square is 4. Sine inverse sine cancel, x is equal to what? 2 2s are 4. 1 plus 4 is 5. This is x value. Y, here directly we don't know how to find 1 by 2 is there. We don't know formula. I'll consider this tan inverse 4 by 3 is theta. From this tan theta, what you'll get? 4 by 3. From this tan theta, this is theta means opposite, adjacent. This is how much? 5. I'll find out cos theta. Cos means what? Adjacent by hypotenuse. Why I am finding cos only have reason. Y is equal to, this will become sine, this is theta by 2, that is theta by 2. We have formula cos theta in terms of only sine, that is 1 minus 2 sine square theta by 2. From this formula, sine theta by 2 will get under root of 1 minus cos theta by 2, inside root only, this is the value you will get. That's why I am finding cos theta only. Now y is equal to under root of 1 minus cos theta value, how much we got already? 3 by 5 by 2. Take LCM, 5 minus 3, that is 2, 2 by 5 by 2, 2 to cancel. That is y is what? 1 by root 5. Which is the greatest? Clearly, x is the greatest value. So x is greater than y. That is okay. But still we need to find one more equation, because two options having x greater than y. Three options. I will find out 1 minus x. 1 minus 4 by 5. That is 1 by 5. So 1 minus x equal to, if you take square of y, what will you get? 1 by 5 only, now that's why y square equal to 1 minus x and x greater than y. These two conditions there in which option? Option 1 is the correct one. Next, question number 25. The value of summation m is equal to 1 to n tan inverse of 2m by m power 4 plus m square plus 2 is a value we need to find. Already I said this type of series is there. Try to convert in the form of tan inverse x minus tan inverse y form to get any factors to satisfy numerator also. I am writing this one 1 plus m power 4 plus m square plus 1. Summation m is equal to 1 to n tan inverse of 2m by 1 plus this one I am writing like this m square plus m plus 1 into m square minus m plus 1. If you multiply these two terms, you will get this expression only. Okay. How to get means by solving the multiple type of questions, this type of models, you will get idea. Summation m is equal to 1 to n. Now the numerator I am writing subtraction of these two factors. M square plus m plus 1 minus of m square minus m plus 1 by 1 plus m square plus m plus 1 into m square minus m plus 1. If you subtract also m square cancel, 1, 1 cancel, get m minus of minus plus 2m you will get. Now this is clearly in the form of tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. Now substitute the value of m from 1 to n. First I will substitute 1 ma. 1 means what? 1 plus 1, that is 3. Tan inverse of 1 square 1 minus 1, 1 1 cancel, you will get 1. If you substitute 2, 2 square 4, 4 plus 2 6, 6 plus 1 7 minus 2 square 4 minus 2, 2, 2 plus 1 3 plus and so on. Last we are substituting n, n square plus n plus 1 minus tan inverse of n square minus n plus 1. For this preceding you will get that also positive value. This all terms will cancel except this value and this value. By expanding you will get my series. Again we need to simplify. Tan inverse of n square plus n plus 1 minus tan inverse 1. Again which formula? Tan inverse x minus tan inverse y formula. Tan inverse of x minus y by 1 plus x into y, product will get same only na, 1 1 cancel, tan inverse of this simplified still, take n is common from this, you will get n plus 1, here 1 plus 1 2 plus, take n common, n into n plus 1, same expression there in which option, option 2 is the correct one. Next question number 26. ABCR belongs to real numbers. We need to find a summation of tan inverse root of small a into a plus b plus c by bc. For easy purpose, I'll consider this a plus b plus c some k or t, nothing, anything you can take. It's just value only, no need to change this overall value. Root of, I can take KA by BC. Summation means what will get like this. Three terms, alternate to changes. KA by BC. Next, tan inverse of KB by CA. Plus tan inverse of root of KC by AB. We need to find this value. For this two, I'll apply tan inverse x plus tan inverse y formula. Tan inverse of root of KA by BC plus root of KB by CA divided by 1 minus root of KA by BC root of KB by CA plus tan inverse of root of KC by AB. Here in numerator, what is LCM? Root C is there already. So root AB into root C will get total. So root K is a common in numerator I can take. Root A into root A will get A. Root B into root B, that is B. By what is the LCM will get? Root of ABC by 1 minus root K into root K, that is K, into root of AB by what the remaining term? Root AB into root C, and root C will get C only. Root AB gets cancelled. This C value comes to numerator. Tan inverse of root K into A plus B into C, this value comes to denominator ma, root AB into root C into 1 minus K. Yes, C will multiply here also, that's why you get C minus K, because LCM you need to take before taking to numerator. C minus K will get from this tan inverse of root K into, from this A plus B, what will get? K minus C, substitute in the numerator. K minus C, C by root C will get root C in the numerator by root of AB into C minus K. Tan inverse of, I will take minus common from this, so minus root of KC into C minus K. In this minus common ma, by root of AB into C minus K. So both gets cancelled. Now what remaining? Tan inverse of minus is there. Tan can be negative in second quadrant. Tan inverse of this complete minus tan. This is value what? Directly means we can't take. We can do one thing here. Small correction. Here what here? For everything sum is there ma, this value plus root of KC by AB plus tan inverse root of KC by AB. For every term is there. This minus we got, we can convert this one into condition wise. Pi minus, the value wise you want means exactly, before only consider it here better, one small thing, only for one value will apply, remaining you can simplify easily. What this value you take, this tan inverse root of KC by AB, I can take some A, okay? Then root of KC by AB is a tan A, okay? Now negative term is there, that's why tan inverse of minus tan A. Minus tan A, I can write tan of pi minus A, 180 minus theta. Now tan inverse cancel, you get pi minus A. The left side I taken only the sum of these two values, ma. Okay. Now this A is this, taking this side. Already left side we have tan inverse of root of KA by BC, tan inverse of root of KB by CA, minus of minus means plus A, is equal to what? Pi. A means what? Tan inverse of root of KC by AB. This all three sum we need to find out. That's why what is the answer we got? Pi is the answer. That's why pi answer means option 4 is the correct one. Okay, na? A means the this value only, ma. So I'm not writing again A value. Next, question number 27. What 27? Tan inverse x whole square plus cot inverse x whole square equal to pi square by 4, then we need to find x value. Okay, this is clearly in the form of a square plus b square. We can write a plus b whole square minus 2ab minus 2 tan inverse x into cot inverse x equal to pi square by 4. Tan inverse x plus cot inverse x value what? Pi by 2. Pi by 2 whole square is what? Pi square by 4 minus 2 tan inverse x into cot inverse x equal to pi square by 4. Both gets cancel. Minus 2 tan inverse x into cot inverse x equal to 0. Tan inverse x equal to 0. But cot inverse x is 0 is possible at which angle? At pi by 2. But pi by 2 is given, not this value. Either cot inverse x equal to 0. X equal to tan 0. Tan 0 how much? 0. But here x is equal to cot 0. Cot 0 what? Infinity. Okay, now that's why. But infinity is not given. So x is equal to 0 is given. That is option 1 is the correct one. Infinity is not given. Next question number 28. We need to find the value of sine of tan inverse 3 by 4. Whole square. Cos of tan inverse 3 by 4. To find this one, I will consider tan inverse 3 by 4 is theta. And this 3 by 4 equal to what will get tan theta? According to Pythagoras theorem, this is theta. Tan means opposite by adjacent. For 3, 4, what is the combination? Hypotenuse is 5. I will find out from this sine theta. Sin theta is 3 by 5. Cos theta 4 by 5. Substitute in that symbols. Sin, this complete value theta, that is sin theta whole square. Cos, this is theta, that is cos theta. Sin theta whole square means 3 by 5 whole square, that is 9 by 25. This is 4 by 5. LCM is what? 25. 9 plus 5 times will multiply. 5 fours are 20. What is the answer? 29 by 25 is the answer. That is option 1 is the correct. Next. Question number 29. D is the common difference of A1, A2 and so on, AN plus 1. That means D can be, we can take A2 minus A1 or A3 minus A2 and so on. An plus 1 before term is what? An. This common difference will get. Here the value we need to find tan inverse of D by 1 plus A1 A2 plus tan inverse of D by 1 plus A2 A3 plus and so on plus tan inverse of D by 1 plus An plus 1 into An. This value we need to find out, or An, no problem. Here in this place of D, I can take here A2 minus A1 because that is also common difference. Plus tan inverse of here, I can take A3 minus A2 plus tan inverse of An plus 1 minus An by 1 plus An plus 1 An. Each and every value here and so on, ma, plus and so on. Each and every value changed in terms of tan inverse x minus tan inverse y form. Tan inverse A2 minus tan inverse A1 plus tan inverse A3 minus tan inverse A2 plus and so on. Tan inverse AN plus 1 minus tan inverse AN. This term preceding will get plus value. All cancel except this last value and this first value. Tan inverse of AN plus 1 minus tan inverse of A1 is the simplified value. That is option 1 is the correct. Next, the last one. Question number 30. We need to find the domain of y equal to cos inverse of x square minus 4. First of all, remember, we know the domain of cos. Whatever x is there, it is lying between minus 1 to plus 1. Send minus 4 that side, plus will becomes minus 1 plus 4, that is 3. X square less than equal to 5. So root means what we will get here? Two conditions we will get. Total, we need to find that all values. First, this one I will take. 3 less than or equal to x square means x square is greater than or equal to 3. X square equal less than or equal to 5. 2 we need to find separately, the values wise. Here the condition, first one. X square minus 3, I can take root 3 whole square greater than or equal to 0. X square minus a square greater than or equal to 0, then x is belongs to open interval minus infinity comma minus root 3 closed interval union root 3 comma infinity. Similarly, this one you can write x square minus root 5 whole square less than or equal to 0. This one directly will get x is belongs to closed interval minus root 5 comma root 5. This is in the form of x square minus a square less than or equal to 0, then x is belongs to closed interval minus a comma a. But for this two we need to write common domain. Take real line from minus infinity to infinity. First, minus root 5 is the least, and then minus root 3. Sorry, 1 minute. Condition wise, what are the given options? Okay, minus root 5 to minus root 3, and next root 3 is the least, root 5 is the highest. Here the first interval, what here? From minus infinity to minus root 3, from here to here is there, but next one more is what? Root 3 to infinity is there. Second one, from minus root 5 to plus root 5. From here to here, not taking this real part, only you will take from here to here only. In between minus root 3 plus root 5, we should not take. From minus root 5 to root 5, overall will come, including this area. But here restricted, minus root 3 below, root 3 above. That's why we are not taking this, and this part also we need to take. We are not taking from minus root 5 to infinity also. Finally, common domain is x belongs to closed interval minus root 5 comma minus root 3 union root 3 comma root 5. Clear? First interval from minus infinity to minus root 3, but this part we are not taking, only this part. This also we are not taking, and this part we are taking. And root 5 to infinity also we are not taking. This is a common domain for this given conditions. That is, option 4 is the correct one. That's all, ma. So these are the key answers for these questions. For remaining, which we not discussed, 7 to 15, that is up, we have in material. You check once, solutions. Thank you.